In the previous videos, we've created a document type with some properties, a content node with values, and rendered the content on the front end with the help of a template. And we now have a front end with some content and a basic HTML structure. In this video, I'll introduce you to the concept of master templates. This feature is quite handy when you have a large website. So let's get started. Currently, we have a set of different elements in our HTML structure for the website. There's a navigation bar up here, a banner with a title and a subtitle, and if we scroll down to the bottom of the page, we have a footer here as well. Now, these are all the elements that we want to show on all pages of our website. Rather than copying and pasting all the static text into each template, we are going to create a master template. The master template will hold all the static elements for our site. So, let's go to the back office and take a look at a homepage template. What we want to do here is remove all these HTML tags, that is the head section, body navigation, and the jumbotron here with the title and subtitle. And then the footer section along with the rest of the template from the bottom. That will leave the homepage template with only the main container section here, which contains the body text, the gray banner area, the blog post, and the call to action, which is specific to the homepage. Let's first create the master template before removing the content from the homepage template. We'll right-click on the templates folder, select create, and we'll call our master template master. Pretty obvious, right? Let's save it. The next step here is to copy the homepage template and paste it directly into a master template here. We need to make sure not to override the top section. As you can see, we have two references, one to the master page and the other to the home page. I'm going to remove the published content line and paste it on the top here since we're using the fallback type in the footer text, and delete the homepage reference. All right, now let's get rid of everything that's in the main container. So, from the div class container here, we'll take everything all the way down to where the footer begins and just delete it. We'll add a few lines here in the middle and we'll come back to that in a moment. Okay, let's save the master template and go to the homepage template where we want to get rid of all the stuff that we just added in the master template. That means the HTML head, body navigation, jumbotron with title and subtitle. Let's get rid of all of that. And I'll just clean this up a bit. And we'll scroll down all the way to the bottom and get rid of the footer until the closing HTML tag. Now, for the homepage template to use the HTML structure from the master template we just created, we need to define it. We can do so by clicking up here. From the dialog, we'll select our master template. And you'll see that the layout is updated with the master template file. Let's go ahead and save it. Oh, we are sent to the settings dashboard. That's because our homepage is now nested under the master template. This way, we can easily identify which template inherits from our master template. Now, the final thing we need to do is head back to our master template and make sure that all the content from our homepage template and the other templates that we'll add later on is rendered from our master template. We'll find the empty space we had left earlier on and render the content from the other templates by using a method called renderBody. This will take the contents of the template using the master template and render it out right here. You can either type this out like I just did or click section and choose render child template. All right, let's save the master template. And that's all we need to do in order to set up our master template. It's time to take a look at our front end. If we did everything right, we should see the exact same page as before. Let's refresh the page. That looks like the one before. That's awesome. We can now use the master template for all the templates we'll be setting up in the coming videos and ensure that our website has a consistent look. In the next video, we'll extend our website by repeating the process of creating and configuring document types, creating content, and setting up templates. That's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.